Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Ryan Wells here with another video for you from Blue Line Optics. Today, we're going to talk about reticle types, and we're going to get to most of the different reticle types that are out there. Probably not every single one of them, but we're going to get to the ones that are the most common so that you're really aware of what the person is talking about when they're trying to tell you what type of reticle that they have on a scope that you're trying to buy, that you're trying to use, or whether you're just sitting there just talking to a couple of people. You're going to be able to know what you're talking about. Now, this is really important to understand because reticle types are a pretty big part of a lot of companies' marketing agendas when they sell rifle scopes. And this is because each different reticle type is going to have a different use for it. And so the one that you're looking for is going to really depend on what you're trying to use it for. Now, are you trying to just shoot some targets? You know, are you just trying to target practice? Are you trying to hunt ground squirrels at 300 yards? Are you trying to make a 1500 yard shot? All those questions are going to affect what kind of reticle you really want. And each one, in each different reticle type is going to have a different kind of use when it comes to whatever you're trying to use it for. So what we're going to do is we're going to go through each different reticle type and what it's used for, what you might use it for, etc., what it's going to look like, etc., etc. And then we're going to take a look at a couple of the different scopes that I have here. Right, so I have the Athlon Neos, then I got the Vortex Crossfire 2, and then I got the Athlon Argus BTR. And we're going to take a look at what I specifically use them for and maybe take you out to the range and show you a couple of them in action and stuff like that. So stay tuned, it's going to be a lot of fun. So the first reticle that we're going to start with is the BDC reticle. BDC stands for Bullet Drop Compensator, and it's noted by these little hash marks that are going to be below the center of the intersecting lines on the reticle or the crosshair. Okay, and so those lines represent a specific distance between each other, and typically if you're getting an SFP scope, the distance between those two lines is going to be measured at the highest magnification setting. Now, if you have an FFP scope like the Athlon Argus BTR here, those lines are going to be the same distance regardless of what magnification you have adjusted on there. And that's because in an FFP scope, the reticle is going to be right behind the objective lens. So when you go to zoom in and zoom out, that reticle is going to get bigger with the image. On an SFP scope like these two right here, that's not the case. As you zoom in, the image is going to get bigger, but the reticle won't get bigger. So typically what companies do is they measure what the difference is between those hash marks at the highest magnification setting. That way you know exactly how much of a distance there is between those two hash marks when it is at that magnification setting. And if you want to know the distance between those two at any other magnification setting, you're probably going to have to go in and do that manually for yourself. But we have a whole video about SFP and FFP, and I highly suggest you check it out there. And we talk about the BDC reticle first because a lot of other reticles are going to be loosely based on it. So this right here is not that. This is what we call a mill reticle, a Christmas tree reticle, and it's not it has hash marks like a BDC reticle does, like the Crossfire here, except it's going to be a little bit more complex. So it's technically a different reticle, but it's based on the concept of the BDC reticle right there. And then the next reticle we want to talk about is the mil dot reticle. And with that, we're going to talk about the MOA reticle too. Mil dot gets its name because on both the vertical and horizontal lines that are on the reticle, it's going to have these little dots. And what those dots represent are exactly 1 mil apart from each other. So at any point on that dot, it is exactly 1 mil away from the next dot up or the next dot down. Or if it's on the sides to the left and to the right. And then the dots that are right by the crosshairs, that's going to be 1 mil from the center of those crosshairs. So if it's the center of the dot, it's 1 mil from the center of the next dot up. If it's the top of the dot, it's exactly 1 mil from the top of the dot up. That easy. Now, the Marines sometimes use a reticle that is similar to the mil dot, except they're going to be more oval shaped. They're kind of cool looking, but it's the same basic concept. Now, we talk about the MOA reticle there too, because MOA reticles are going to come in hash marks. In fact, this BDC reticle right here is an MOA reticle because the hash marks are done in MOA apart and not mil apart. And But it's the same basic concept, right? So those hash marks are exactly one MOA or half an MOA apart from each other, just depending on what the subtension is. And so now we get to the Christmas tree reticle. So like I mentioned earlier, the Athlon Argus here does have a Christmas tree reticle on it. And how you know what a Christmas tree reticle is that below the crosshairs, remember we were talking about the bullet drop compensators below the crosshairs, what they're gonna have in addition to that are these little lines at those hash marks that go out a specific distance. And those specific distances are all going to be measured in mil or MOA, just depending on whatever it is that your scope subtensions are. And we're gonna talk about subtensions here in a little bit, so don't worry if you're confused on that. Now, these are excellent for long range shooting because you can make really accurate adjustments without necessarily adjusting the dials on your scope, right? So if you see that you have to go down 1 mil and left 3 mil or something like that, you don't even necessarily have to make this adjustment here. You just alter your scope down 1 mil and then left, right? It's that easy because you're gonna have those little marks that are on the reticle right there that you can just line up with the target by yourself. No more messing with this, no more re-zeroing your scope, none of that, it's great. Okay, and that leads us into subtensions. So subtensions are usually only valid on FFP scopes. We only really use them on FFP scopes because remember, SFP scopes, the distance between hash marks are only gonna be at a certain magnification level, usually the highest magnification level. On FFP scopes, they're constant regardless of the magnification level that you have. Okay, so what a subtension is it's just a constant distance between hash marks on the reticle, no matter what magnification it is. Okay, so what, especially on the Argus here, it has hash marks in 0.5 mil increments. It'll have like a short hash mark that's 0.5, and then a long one that's 1, then a short one that's 1.5, then a long one that's 2. And that's the same no matter what this magnification setting is. And those are so incredibly useful when you're measuring out long distances. It's absolutely fantastic. So the next reticle is the duplex reticle, and that's actually what's featured here on the Athlon Neos. So the duplex reticle is what you would picture to be your classic crosshair of a reticle, okay? So the duplex reticle is going to have just the lines intersecting in the middle of the reticle and at all around the edges about till about a quarter to a third of the way in, the lines are gonna be bolded. Now, hunters find this extremely useful because it helps eliminate that background chatter that you get with all the foliage and stuff like that that might be behind your target. And so it really helps them narrow in on what the target is that they're aiming at. Now, usually these are on single focal plane scopes. I personally use the Athlon Neos for target practice because I'm not that big of a hunter. So I typically use it for target practice because it's just a handy little scope to use when I'm just out at the range and I'm shooting for under 200 yards or under 300 yards and whatnot. But a lot of people find it really handy for hunting applications as well. And then the next reticle is the German reticle. So the German reticle is really similar to the duplex reticle, except the 12 o'clock, the 12 o'clock line at the top does not have that thick bolded line. It's only the bottom three. Okay, and it's called the German reticle because it was pioneered by the Germans. And I mean, if you have ever played a Call of Duty game, you'll notice that on their sniper rifles, like that they have those three bolded lines, and then the center doesn't usually have anything in there. But in this case, we do have intersecting lines that make a T at the center of those reticles, and then sometimes they'll also have ones that go all the way to the top too. Now, a lot of companies brand these German reticles as their own, like they'll call them like German number 4 or something like that, but typically this is just called the German reticle. And then we come to the dot reticle. Now, the dot reticle is just that. It's just a dot. It's not really useful unless you're shooting really short range targets or you're doing target practice or something like that. It's basically just a red dot scope, except it might have some magnification adjustment and whatnot. I don't actually even have one of these, but I mean, I shot them and I've shot red dots. It's not used for anything besides really short range shooting and maybe target practice. And so we talked about my scopes a little bit throughout the video, but now I kind of want to go into more detail with them. Like the last one we talked about was the Athlon Neos here. Now it's a duplex reticle. Again, like I said, a lot of people really like this for hunting. It's very useful when it comes to hunting because the bold, thick lines on the edges really help block out that foliage. Me personally, I just like using it for target practice just because I like using the different scopes and stuff like that, really getting used to them and obviously reviewing them and things like that. And it's a pretty cheap little scope. Like this was only about $90, which is pretty good, and especially compared to a longer range scope like the Argus here. But yeah, typically these are used for hunters. I use it for target practice. If I hunted, this would probably be what I would use, or some variation of it, I would assume. And then there's the Vortex Crossfire here. I actually just mounted and zeroed this 2 days ago. And this is just a simple BDC reticle. But instead of only having the hash marks dropping down from the center of the reticle, we also have hash marks to the side of it. Now, again, I just use this reticle for playing around, but I also know people who use it for, you know, hunting as well and shooting ground squirrels and stuff like that. It's a pretty nice little scope. I don't know how much it costs MSRP because I got it for free with my Ruger American here. Which is actually a pretty sweet little feature that Vortex and Ruger paired up to do. And I'd like to see them do some more of it. But yeah, pretty sweet little scope. I would compare it a lot to the Athlon Neos. It doesn't have the parallax adjustment like the Neos does right there. But it is, in all other senses, it is extremely similar to the Neos and similar usages. Just short range shooting. I use it just to play and just for target practice and stuff like that. But I could definitely see somebody using it for hunting and for medium range shooting too. Like anything up, you could probably be pretty useful to up to 300 to 500 yards or so. And then we get to the Argus BTR, the Athlon Argus BTR. Now this is for longer range shooting. And you could get up to 1,000 yards with it, maybe even a little bit further on. The total distance adjustment is, I think, 18 mil, so it might not be able to get you much farther than that. But this is a first focal plane scope. It's got a Christmas tree reticle in it, and this particular one is in mil increments, not mil dots, they're just hash marks, but it's in mil increments. And the reticle is extremely useful for, like I said earlier, long distance shooting. Anytime you're going to be taking multiple factors into consideration, like gravity and distance and windage and things like that. It's got the windage holdovers on the Christmas tree part, and that makes it extremely useful for those long distance shots. So there's three completely different scopes. The Crossfire probably could be used for a little bit longer range than what I use it for, but I just don't use it for that. And then the Neos, more for hunting. The Argus, more for long range shooting. All right, everybody, that wraps up our video on reticle types. Now what I want to know is, what's your favorite reticle type? What's the one that you're going to use, and what are you going to use it for? Also, have you noticed any other kinds of reticle types that maybe we left out that you want me to do a little bit more research into? I'd absolutely love to. Leave them in the comments below. Be sure to check out the blog post on the website too, because that's got a few goodies in it that we didn't mention in the video. Anyway, we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.